sailors can really...
I also learned this is big job.
States Navy to what we will sure will become a very historic occasion in the history of the John F. Kennedy. We have standing before you, Mr. President, 26 of our nation's finest. These are true Navy professionals who are re-enlisting tonight for a total of 100 years of service. On this very special day when we observe Independence Day, the 75th anniversary of naval aviation, and Miss Liberty's 100th anniversary. After the re-enlistment, Chief John Reagan from Jacksonville, Florida, will accept his appointment by the President of the United States as the Chief Warrant Officer in the United States Navy. I will now read the re-enlistment oath. If you will raise your right hand and state after me. I do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same, and that I will obey the orders of the President of the United States and the orders of the officers appointed over me. According to regulations and the Uniform Code of Military Justice, so help me God. Congratulations on your decision to renew your service in the world's greatest Navy on board the world's greatest aircraft carrier, the John F. Kennedy. Re-enlistees, pose. Thank you. Are you ready to repeat the oath of office? Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, John C. Reagan, having been appointed a Chief of the United States Navy, do accept such appointment and do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same, that I take this obligation freely, without any mental reservation or purpose or evasion, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of which I am about to enter. So help me God. Chief Warrant Officer Reagan, welcome to the USS John F. Kennedy Wharton.
Throughout the land, and many of the former colonists, they were just starting to call themselves Americans, set off cannons and marched in fife and drum parades. But a contrast with the sober scene that has taken time to harden. It was noted at the time that they pledged their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor. And that was more than ever. Each of those men knew the penalty for high treason to get wrong. See it without his seconds. They were brave. They stayed brave through all the bloodshed of the coming years. Their courage, freedom, and nation We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, rededicated his liberty and freedom to torch. We reflected on all the millions who came here in search of a dream of freedom, inaugurated in Independence Hall. We have courage in coming great distances and settling a foreign land and then passing on the answer. It is a hope that someday every people and every nation of the world will know the blessings of liberty. And it's the hope of millions all around the world. In the last few years, I've spoken at Westminster to the Rome, the Imperial Palace in Japan, and the ancient city of Beijing. I've seen the beaches of Normandy and Gila. The father who had once dreamed of seeing again the place where he and so many brave others had landed, she said, I'll always be proud. And I've seen the successes to these brave men, the young Americans in uniform all over the world, the young Americans like you here tonight, the man, the mighty USS, the bravery of the battlefield, I mean the bravery of brotherhood. All through our history, our presidents and leaders have spoken, once learned this lesson late in life. They worked so closely together in Philadelphia for independence. But once that was gained, we did. For years, their estrangement lasted. But then, when both had retired, Jefferson at 68, to Monticello, and Adams at 76, to Quincy, they began through their letters to speak again so deeply. It carries about correspondence with his co-signer of the Declaration of Independence, to the times when, beset with difficulties and dangers, we were fellow laborers in the same cause, struggling for what is most valuable to man, his right to self-government, laboring always at the same oar, with this lesson in brotherhood, in tolerance for each other, this insight into America's strength as a nation. And when both died, the same day, within hours of each other, this, that the things that unite us, America's past, of which we're so proud.
Look! I'm walking everybody's side. Jesus, don't tell me that!